Hey guys, welcome back to the very exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess. In today's video, we're designing a brochure cover template in Photoshop. In the previous video, we have designed a brochure cover both front and back, along with the perspective reference in Illustrator. So let's jump to Photoshop and create out this editable template. We are in Photoshop now. Let's drag in the exported images from Illustrator and create out an editable template. So here we go. The images are inside. Now let's drag in these images and create out a template in the main file. So here we go, just click and drag and drop. And before you go further, let's convert this into smart object. This will maintain the quality of the image even though you scale it down. Control T and scale it down, and let's place it this much size. Okay, enter. So here we go, we got the image. Let's place it in the center or maybe a little bit aside. Now let's drag in the other design, the front page. Click, drag and drop, and let's convert this into smart object again. So right click, smart object, control T, scale it down, and let's do the placement. So I select the distort option and let's keep the anchor points to the corners of this design, of this perspective rectangle. That's looking great. Here, the last corner, just place it in the proper place and enter. So we got this. Now let's work out the details. First of all, if you see, this is looking like it's separate, so we have to merge this up. So we'll create first of all, let's duplicate this one more and keep the original on the top, and we'll work out with the duplicate layers because we can edit it anytime anyway. So this one, let's create a layer on top of this, and let's with the brush tool, let's draw out color. So with the IP card, select this color, and with a soft brush, let's scale it down. Okay, it's a little bit up, full 100%, and let's merge this up. So click, drag. So you can see we are merging it like that. So you can see it's looking like it's one object now. We need that. Here I can reduce the opacity and work out a little bit here. Let's zoom it out, and it's looking great. We got that nice shadow, nice depth, and that's overall it's great. Now let's work out with the main object. So this one, let's hide this up a little bit. This one, let's do some adjustments. So control T, and I'll just use the wrap option to give some distortion, like a bulging up, like that effect. Let's check it out and click place. So we got this. Let's see. That's great. Let's create a layer down this, and with a pen tool, let's draw out an inner sheet, like the brochure you're putting inside. So just click, click, and a little bit outside, then around one around here and there, and let's make selection. Okay, let's fill this up with some this orange color or the backspace, and you got it. Control T like that. We can control T and we can just scale it down a little bit like that. Enter. So we got it. You can see, nice. And now let's work out with the details. So to create that out, let's do some duplication. So I'll just duplicate this one more, and I'll just make it overlay like that, and you got that nice sharp effect. Let's reduce it to 20, then again duplicate this one more, and this time I'll change this to screen, and this will highlight it and reduce the opacity a little bit more. Now duplicate this one more time, and we'll create some 3D depth, like a little bit of shadow on the top. So let's use the multiply option, and you can see the effect here. We can increase the shadow a little bit, and let's mask it up, and with the eraser tool, I'll just erase a few of this stuff. So let's give some selecting that with the 100% erasing capability. Let's erase it from here. So just erase it. Okay. And let's balance everything. So this one, let's reduce it to a little bit this much. This one, let's keep it around 30 maybe. And this one, I think it's very large, so let's see. Okay, this one is great. So you got to see that we got a nice depth here. Next thing we need to do is we need to create out that shadows inside. So let's create few more sheets inside that. So I'll just duplicate this one more time. And this one, I'll just push it here. Alt backspace. Let's convert the color to maybe white, light white. Alt backspace. So that you can see the as if it's inside it. So let's do that. Okay. Let's see. That's great. We can erase the later portions like from here. Let's erase it out 100%. Okay. So that we can see that. And next thing, let's give some drop shadow. So I'll just use this and go to double click on this drop shadow, and you can see that I'll just do is reduce the distance and the blur size. Okay, so that we can see feel like as if something is there on the top of it. Now let's give some effect. So select this layer on top one. I'll just duplicate this one more. And on below surface, let's convert this into like rasterized layer. Let's duplicate this one more time and hide the top one. And this one, let's give some drop shadow. So use the drop shadow option and let's play around. You can see we got that nice effect. Let's increase the distance and reduce the blurriness like that. Let's reduce the opacity. Okay, that's looking great. Let's check it out. Overall, it's looking great. Modify the distance and a little bit with the angles. Okay, let's click the OK button. That's what. Now, if you see, we have got lots of shadows here. We have to delete that out. So with the eraser tool, with the sharp edge tool, let's delete all these extra. Just delete this out from here. Like that, and from this corner also, let's delete it. This, everything deleted out. So, as if it's inside it. Now, in the same way, I'll just use this. And if you see, and before that, Alt Backspace, and let's fill this up with black color, Alt Backspace. Control D. Now, let's do the settings effect, blur, Gaussian blur. You can see that sharp edge. So let's do that, click OK, and let's do some placement and let's reduce the opacity. And now let's erase out all the rest portion. Eraser tool, erase out unnecessary pieces from here, everywhere like that. Let the extra unnecessary pieces. Next thing, let's create out a new layer. So let's create a new layer on top, and with the brush tool, with the color white selected, let's reduce the brush stroke to around this much and let's draw a few stuff. So from here, click, okay. Then after that, let's click and drag. Next thing, let's give some shadow here. So with the brush tool selected, black, that's gray, then reduce the, let's make it soft and reduce the brush strokes. From here, let's reduce the opacity a little bit more. From here, click, drag, and you got that nice shadow. So here you go, see. So we have given that. Next thing we need to do is let's give some drop shadow to the main body. So now our template design is almost ready. Only few things are left. We can add some drop shadows here. Like shadows, it's looking flat. So I'll just select that and duplicate this one more. And this one, I'll just make it multiply. And you got a nice shade brown. And with the mask on, let's erase out the center portion. So with the eraser tool, use the brush, soft brush, like that, increase these. And before that, let's switch off the drop shadow. And let's erase it out from here. So from here, just erase it out, leaving that dot portion there like that. From there like that. And let's decrease the opacity so that you can feel as if it's there. And if you check it out now, it's looking like real. Last thing we need to add is, I'll just select everything and leaving that one stuff like that and group this up. So Control G to group it up, and if you see, it's in one layer, and this one is our main design. So if you enter this, you can edit it here and it will be automatically updated at here to this file, our main file. And you have to save it before, if you edit something, like you edit a text, go to file, save it, and this will automatically update it here. So that's not an issue. Next thing is, let's give some effects. So I'll just duplicate this one more and convert this into rasterized image so that I can give some style to this. So like, let's convert this smart object. So convert this into again rasterized image, and with the selection tool, let's save it around, let's give it around 100 pixels, and let's play around with the selection tool. Well, like this from here. Okay, now Control Shift I and filter blur Gaussian blur, and let's give some effect. So here we go, let's increase the blur effect, and you can see the difference here, like focus and unfocus, and click OK. Control D and you got that nice effect here. So this is how we have created the amazing cover for our brochure, which is totally unique, and we have understand how to create a template of that, which is totally editable. You can use this file and create your own design, and after that just replace the smart object with that design, and it will, your template will be ready. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.